Oh, hello there. My name is Gattu and welcome back to another video. In this video, I'll be talking about the new patch 7.06 and the new changes in the items. If you are new to this channel, feel free to subscribe and hit that like button if you enjoy the video. So let's get started. So the first item that has been changed is the Eagle Lens. The spell amplification has increased from 5% to 6%, and it now has a new recipe to make the Eagle Lens. Earlier we had to purchase the energy booster, ring of health and the recipe, but now we have to buy the energy booster, void stone and the recipe. So there will be a good change, because earlier we used to had plus 8 health regen and now will have plus 100% mana regen. So I think it will go really well with Zeus. And now to the next item, guys, the blade mill. The cooldown has increased from 18 to 20%. It's not that important, but it's gonna affect as well. And now, guys, the Blightstone is one of the major item changes. It is no longer a unique attack modifier. What this means is that Blightstone is now gonna stack with each and every item, so expect a lot of PA pickers in this patch, guys. And now to the next item, guys, the Bloodthorn. The Bloodthorn's cooldown has increased from 14 to 18. And now to the next item, guys, the Bloodthorn. The Bloodthorn's cooldown has increased from 14 to 18. And now I got a really good news for all the mid players out there. The cost of bottle has reduced from 660 to 650. And now into the next item change, it is the Bracer, guys. The recipe cost has reduced from 190 to 175, so I think it's gonna be really cool to, you know, spend some less coin on Bracer. And now to the next update, guys, the Clarity is now purgeable. So what this means is that if you get attacked by a creep or a tower, the effect of the Clarity is gonna stop. Now into the next item, the Crimson Guard. The Crimson Guard duration has increased from 10 to 12. I mean, that's really good in a team fight. That 2 seconds, it could mean a lot. Now let's jump into the next item, guys, the Daedalus. The damage has increased from 76 to 80, and it's gonna matter a little bit, because the higher the damage you have, the higher the crit you will get. So I think it's a really good update to, you know, having the damage increased. And now into the next update, guys, the Dagon. I really love this item. And it has a new feature now. It will now kill illusions instantly. So I think it's really cool. For example, if I see two Chaos Knight out there and one of them is illusion, I can just destroy one of his illusions. And I think that's really cool. And now into the next item, guys, the Demon Edge. The cost is reduced from 2.4k to 2.2k. And the damage is reduced from 46 to 42. And now to the next update again, guys, the Desolator. Since the Blightstone was not a unique attack modifier, the Desolator as well is not a unique attack modifier. So I'm guessing that in this patch there will be a lot of PA pickers with Desolator and Satanic. So be careful, guys. Don't let the PA farm. Now into the next item, guys, the Enchanted Mango. The cost is reduced from 110 to 100, and the item cannot be sold once bought, and it has to be consumed. So I think it's really cool, you know, but be careful, guys. Don't misclick and waste 100 coins. Now to the next item, guys, the Fury Fire. The cost is reduced from 75 to 70. It doesn't matter that much, but it's gonna affect anyways. And now to the next item, guys, the Four Staff. It now has a new recipe. Earlier it used to have a Staff of Wizardry, Ring of Regen and a recipe, but in the new one we have to buy a Ring of Health instead of a Ring of Regen. So we'll get a bit of more health regen, so that's pretty good. Now to the next item, guys, the Hurricane Pike. It will only give plus 2 health regen, because now we have to purchase the Ring of Health. Now to the next item, guys, the Hand of Midas. The recipe cost has increased from 1550 to 1650, and the XP multiplier has increased as well, which is good to hear, from 1.75 to 1.85. That's really not much, but it definitely helps out. And the gold bonus has reduced from 220 to 200. That's a little bit of disappointment, but I think I can live with that. And now to the next item, guys, the Healing Salve. The Healing Salve buff is now purgeable. What this means is that if you are using Healing Salve and if an enemy creep or a tower hits you, the healing effect is gonna stop. Now into the next item, guys, the Heart of Tarrasque. It now requires a second vitality booster instead of a 1.4k recipe, and the strength bonus has reduced from 45 to 40 and the health bonus has increased from 250 to 500. So I think the people who make Heart of Tarrasque, that's a really cool update for you guys. And now into the next update, guys, the Heaven's Halberd, it can no longer be dispelled by spell immunity, so don't be fooled, guys, buy a BKB. And now into the next item, guys, the Helm of Dominator, it now uses a Ring of Health instead of a 800 gold recipe, and since we are using Ring of Health, the health regeneration has increased from 8 to 10. And now the next item, guys, the Mask of Madness, it now requires a quarterstaff instead of a 700 gold recipe, and it provides plus 20 damage and plus 10 attack speed, but the attack speed has decreased as well from 120 to 110. And there's some good news as well, cause the item can now be disassembled. Now into the next item, guys, the Morbid Mask, the cost has reduced from 1.2k to 1.1k, which is not my MMR, and the bonus damage has reduced from plus 15 to plus 10. And now into the next item, guys, the Solar Crest can be now used as a 25% true strikes chance on attackers, and the Solar Crest armor addition or removal has been reduced from 12 to 10. And now into the next update, guys, the Moonshot, it is one of the best items that I have seen in this patch, because once you consume the Moonshot, it will give half of the bonus night vision when it is consumed. Now into the next item, the Necronomicon. Demonic summoning duration has increased from 40 to 45. And now I got some good news for the support players out there. The cost of Observe Ward has reduced from 65 to 60. So yeah, place a ward and save a life. And now into the next item, guys. The Radiance damage on illusions has reduced from 40 to 35. So it's gonna affect a little bit. And now into the next item, guys, the Radiance. The Radiance damage on illusions has been reduced from 40 to 35. Let's jump into the next item, guys. The Refresher Orb now replenishes charge-based abilities, so which is really cool and is a nice addition. And now into the next item, guys, the Rod of Aetis. It has been reworked again. Earlier we had to, you know, buy 2 Staff of Wizardry and 1 Vitality Booster, and now it takes 1 Staff of Wizardry and 2 Bracer, which is really cool, you know. So there will be a lot of players, you know, making Rod of Aetis in this patch. And now into the next item, guys, the Sage and Nyasha. Both of their recipe cost has been reduced by 100 and their attack speed has been reduced from 15 to 10. And now into the next item, guys, the Mantis Style. The recipe cost has been increased by 100. Now into the next item, guys, the Scythe of Vice. The cooldown has been reduced from 25 to 22, which is really cool because we can spam it even more. And now into the next item, guys, the Shiva's Guard. The cost has been increased from 600 to 650, and the Silver Edge, its cost has increased from 500 to 700. And now into the next item, guys, the Soul Ring. It now requires a mango instead of a 150 recipe. Yay! So yeah, the cost has reduced as well on Soul Ring, which is really cool. And now into the last item of this item change. Honor Shadow Heal now acts as proper regeneration like Salve. Earlier it used to, you know, tick, like used to heal, you know, plus 50 HP and then plus 50, but now it's gonna heal on a specific speed, so which is really cool. And it also has a new recipe. Earlier it used to have a Sage Mask, 2 Gauntlets and a recipe, but now it has a infused raindrop, circlet, ring of protection and recipe. So yeah, there will be plus 1 mana regeneration when you buy Urn of Shadows. So yeah, guys, that was it. If you guys need more patch 7.06 news, updates and gameplays, be sure to leave a like and subscribe to the channel so that you guys don't miss anything. And I'll see you guys next time. Peace out.